Fencing. Fencing is a group of three related combat sports. The three disciplines in modern fencing are the foil, the épée, and the sabre. Winning points are made through contact with an opponent. A fourth discipline, singlestick, appeared in the 1904 Olympics but was dropped after that, and is not a part of modern fencing. Fencing was one of the first sports to be played in the Olympics. Based on the traditional skills of swordsmanship, the modern sport arose at the end of the 19th century, with the Italian school having modified the historical European martial art of classical fencing, and the French school later refining the Italian system. There are three forms of modern fencing, each of which uses a different kind of weapon and has different rules, thus the sport itself is divided into three competitive scenes: foil, épée, and sabre. Most competitive fencers choose to specialize in one weapon only. Competitive fencing is one of the five activities which have been featured in every modern Olympic Games, the other four being athletics, cycling, swimming, and gymnastics. Fencing is governed by Fédération Internationale d'Escrime, FIE. Today, its head office is in Lausanne, Switzerland. The FIE is composed of 145 national federations, each of which is recognized by its state Olympic Committee as the sole representative of Olympic-style fencing in that country. The FIE maintains the current rules used by FIE-sanctioned international events, including World Cups, World Championships and the Olympic Games. The FIE handles proposals to change the rules the first year after an Olympic year in the annual Congress. The U.S. Fencing Association has slightly different rules, but usually adheres to FIE standards. Fencing traces its roots to the development of swordsmanship for duels and self-defense. Fencing is believed to have originated in Spain. Some of the most significant books on fencing were written by Spanish fencers. Treatise on Arms was written by Diego de Valera between 1458 and 1471 and is one of the oldest surviving manuals on Western fencing. In spite of the title, the book of Diego Valera was on heraldry, not about fencing, shortly before dueling came under official ban by the Catholic monarchs. In conquest, the Spanish forces carried fencing around the world, particularly to southern Italy, one of the major areas of strife between both nations. Fencing was mentioned in the play The Merry Wives of Windsor, written sometime prior to 1602. The mechanics of modern fencing originated in the 18th century in an Italian school of fencing of the Renaissance, and under their influence, were improved by the French school of fencing. The Spanish school of fencing stagnated and was replaced by the Italian and French schools. The shift towards fencing as a sport rather than as military training happened from the mid-18th century, and was led by Domenico Angelo, who established a fencing academy, Angelo's School of Arms, in Carlisle House, Soho, London in 1763. There, he taught the aristocracy the fashionable art of swordsmanship. His school was run by three generations of his family and dominated the art of European fencing for almost a century. He established the essential rules of posture and footwork that still govern modern sport fencing, although his attacking and parrying methods were still much different from current practice. Although he intended to prepare his students for real combat, he was the first fencing master to emphasize the health and sporting benefits of fencing more than its use as a killing art, particularly in his influential book L'École des Armes, The School of Fencing, published in 1763. The first regularized fencing competition was held at the inaugural Grand Military Tournament and Assault at Arms in 1880, held at the Royal Agricultural Hall, in Islington in June. The tournament featured a series of competitions between army officers and soldiers. Each bout was fought for 5 hits and the foils were pointed with black to aid the judges. The Amateur Gymnastic and Fencing Association drew up an official set of fencing regulations in 1896. Fencing was part of the Olympic Games in the summer of 1896. Sabre events have been held at every Summer Olympics, foil events have been held at every Summer Olympics except 1908, épée events have been held at every Summer Olympics except in the summer of 1896 because of unknown reasons. Starting with épée in 1933, side judges were replaced by the Laurent Pagan electrical scoring apparatus, with an audible tone and a red or green light indicating when a touch landed. Foil was automated in 1956, sabre in 1988. The scoring box reduced the bias in judging, and permitted more accurate scoring of faster actions, lighter touches, and more touches to the back and flank than before. There are three weapons in modern fencing: foil, épée, and sabre. Each weapon has its own rules and strategies. Equipment needed includes at least two swords, a lame, not for épée, a white jacket, underarm protector, two body and mask cords, knee-high socks, glove and knickers. The foil is a light thrusting weapon with a maximum weight of 500 grams. The foil targets the torso, but not the arms or legs. The foil has a small circular handguard that serves to protect the hand from direct stabs. As the hand is not a valid target in foil, this is primarily for safety. Touches are scored only with the tip. Hits with the side of the blade do not register on the electronic scoring apparatus, and do not halt the action. Touches that land outside the target area, called an off-target touch and signaled by a distinct color on the scoring apparatus, stop the action, but are not scored. Only a single touch can be awarded to either fencer at the end of a phrase. If both fencers land touches within a close enough interval of milliseconds to register two lights on the machine, the referee uses the rules of right of way to determine which fencer is awarded the touch, or if an off-target hit has priority over a valid hit, in which case no touch is awarded. If the referee is unable to determine which fencer has right of way, no touch is awarded. The épée is a thrusting weapon like the foil, but heavier, with a maximum total weight of 775 grams. In épée, the entire body is valid target. The handguard on the épée is a large circle that extends towards the pommel, effectively covering the hand, which is a valid target in épée. Like foil, all hits must be with the tip and not the sides of the blade. Hits with the side of the blade do not register on the electronic scoring apparatus, and do not halt the action. As the entire body is legal target, there is no concept of an off-target touch, except if the fencer accidentally strikes the floor, setting off the light and tone on the scoring apparatus. Unlike foil and saber, épée does not use right-of-way, and awards simultaneous touches to both fencers. However, if the score is tied in a match at the last point and a double touch is scored, the point is null and void. The saber is a light cutting and thrusting weapon that targets the entire body above the waist, except the weapon hand. Saber is the newest weapon to be used. Like the foil, the maximum legal weight of a saber is 500 grams. The hand guard on the saber extends from hilt to the point at which the blade connects to the pommel. This guard is generally turned outwards during sport to protect the sword arm from touches. Hits with the entire blade or point are valid. As in foil, touches that land outside the target area are not scored. However, unlike foil, these off-target touches do not stop the action, and the fencing continues. In the case of both fencers landing a scoring touch, the referee determines which fencer receives the point for the action, again through the use of right-of-way. Most personal protective equipment for fencing is made of tough cotton or nylon. Kevlar was added to top-level uniform pieces, jacket, breeches, underarm protector, lame, and the bib of the mask, following the death of Vladimir Smirnov at the 1982 World Championships in Rome. However, Kevlar is degraded by both ultraviolet light and chlorine, which can complicate cleaning. Other ballistic fabrics, such as Dyneema, have been developed that resist puncture, and which do not degrade the way that Kevlar does. FI rules state that tournament wear must be made of fabric that resists a force of, and that the mask bib must resist twice that amount. The complete fencing kit includes, traditionally, the fencer's uniform is white, and an instructor's uniform is black. This may be due to the occasional pre-electric practice of covering the point off the weapon in dye, soot, or colored chalk in order to make it easier for the referee to determine the placing of the touches. As this is no longer a factor in the electric era, the FI rules have been relaxed to allow colored uniforms, save black. The guidelines also limit the permitted size and positioning of sponsorship logos. Some pistol grips used by foil and épée fencers, main article grip, sport fencing. A set of electric fencing equipment is required to participate in electric fencing. Electric equipment in fencing varies depending on the weapon with which it is used in accordance. The main component of a set of electric equipment is the body cord. The body cord serves as the connection between a fencer and a reel of wire that is part of a system for electrically detecting that the weapon has touched the opponent. There are two types, one for épée, and one for foil and saber. Épée body cords consist of two sets of three prongs, each connected by a wire. One set plugs into the fencer's weapon, with the other connecting to the reel. Foil and saber body cords have only two prongs, or a twist lock bayonet connector, on the weapon side, with a third wire connecting instead to the fencer's lame. The need in foil and saber to distinguish between on and off target touches requires a wired connection to the valid target area. A body cord consists of three wires known as the A, B, and C lines. At the reel connector, and both connectors for épée cords, the B pin is in the middle, The A pin is 1.5 cm to one side of B, and the C pin is 2 cm to the other side of B. This asymmetrical arrangement ensures that the cord cannot be plugged in the wrong way around. In foil, the A line is connected to the lame and the B line runs up a wire to the tip of the weapon. The B line is normally connected to the C line through the tip. When the tip is depressed, the circuit is broken and one of three things can happen. In épée, the A and B lines run up separate wires to the tip. There is no lame. When the tip is depressed, it connects the A and B lines, resulting in a valid touch. However, if the tip is touching your opponent's weapon, their C line, or the grounded strip, nothing happens when it is depressed, as the current is redirected to the C line. Grounded strips are particularly important in épée, as without one, a touch to the floor registers as a valid touch, rather than off target as in foil. In sabre, similarly to foil, the A line is connected to the lame, but both the B and C lines are connected to the body of the weapon. Any contact between your BC line, doesn't matter which, as they are always connected, and your opponent's A line, their lame, results in a valid touch. There is no need for grounded strips in sabre, as hitting something other than your opponent's lame does nothing. In a professional fencing competition, a complete set of electric equipment is needed. A complete set of foil electric equipment includes the electric equipment of sabre is very similar to that of foil. In addition, equipment used in sabre includes épée fencers lack lame, conductive bib, and head cord due to their target area. Also, their body cords are constructed differently as described above. However, they possess all of the other components of a foil fencer's equipment. Techniques or movements in fencing can be divided into two categories, offensive and defensive. Some techniques can fall into both categories, for example the beat. Certain techniques are used offensively, with the purpose of landing a hit on your opponent while holding the right of way, foil and saber. Others are used defensively, to protect against a hit or obtain the right of way. The attacks and defenses may be performed in countless combinations of feet and hand actions. For example, fencer A attacks the arm of fencer B, drawing a high outside parry. Fencer B then follows the parry with a high line riposte. Fencer A, expecting that, then makes his own parry by pivoting his blade under fencer B's weapon, from straight out to more or less straight down, putting fencer B's tip off target and fencer A now scoring against the low line by angulating the hand upwards. Whenever a point is scored, the fencers will go back to their starting mark. The fight will start again after the following commands have been given by the referee in French in international settings: on guard, êtes-vous prêt? Are you ready? I, fence. Fencing has a long history with universities and schools for at least 500 years. At least one style of fencing, Mansur in Germany, is practiced only within universities, notably at Heidelberg. University students compete internationally at the World University Games. The United States holds two national-level university tournaments including the NCAA Championship and the USACFC National Championships tournaments in the USA and the Bucks Fencing Championships in the United Kingdom. Prior to advances in modern weaponry post-World War I, the United States Cavalry taught swordsmanship, mounted and dismounted, in Fort Riley, Kansas at its Mounted Service School. George S. Patton Jr., while still a young lieutenant, was named Master of the Sword, an honor reserved for the top instructor. He invented what came to be known as the Patton Saber, in 1913, based on his studies with M. Cleary Lagetant, reputed to be the finest fencing master in Europe at the time. While teaching at Fort Riley, he wrote two training manuals teaching the art of swordsmanship to Army cavalry officers, Saber Exercise 1914 and Diary of the Instructor in Swordsmanship. Equipment costs and the relatively small scale of the sport limits university fencing to a small number of schools. National fencing organizations have set up programs to encourage more students to fence. Examples include the Regional Youth Circuit Program in the USA and the Leon Paul Youth Development Series in the UK. In recent years, attempts have been made to introduce fencing to a wider and younger audience, by using foam and plastic swords, which require much less protective equipment. This makes it much less expensive to provide classes, and thus easier to take fencing to a wider range of schools than traditionally has been the case. There is even a competition series in Scotland, the Plastic and Foam Fencing Fun League, specifically for primary and early secondary school-age children using this equipment. The UK hosts two national competitions in which schools compete against each other directly, the Public Schools Fencing Championship, a competition only open to independent schools, and the Scottish Secondary Schools Championships, open to all secondary schools in Scotland. It contains both teams and individual events and is highly anticipated. Schools organise matches directly against one another and school-age pupils can compete individually in the British Youth Championships. Many universities in Ontario, Canada have fencing teams that participate in an annual inter-university competition called the WA Finals. The Venetian School of Fencing is a style of fencing that occurred in Venice in the early 12th century, and prevailed until the beginning of the 19th century. The basics of the Venetian fencing are expounded in the following five treatises. The Venetians were masters of the art, and shared with their colleagues of Bologna the sound principles of fencing known as Bolognese or Venetian. For the first time Venetian fencing was detailed in some directions, it was described the properties of different parts of the blade, which were used in defense and offense. With this approach, the swordsman had an idea of one thing, what now we calling like center of percussion. It was suggested some divisions of a sword. The blade was divided into four parts, the first two parts from ephesus should be used for protection, the third done near the center of the blow was used for striking, and the fourth part at the tip was used for pricking. The German school of fencing is a historical combat system, a style of fencing that was widespread in the Holy Roman Empire and existed in the late Middle Ages, Renaissance and early modern times, from the end of 14th to 17th century. The first document of the German heritage, which describes the methods of fencing, is considered to be the manuscript I.33 which was written around 1300. Neapolitan fencing is a style of fencing that originated in the city of Naples at the beginning of the 15th century. Neapolitan fencing school is considered to be one of the most powerful fencing schools in Italy. Other variants include wheelchair fencing for those with disabilities, chair fencing, one-hit épée, one of the five events which constitute modern pentathlon and the various types of non-Olympic competitive fencing. Chair fencing is similar to wheelchair fencing, but for the able-bodied. The opponents set up opposing chairs and fence while seated, all the usual rules of fencing are applied. An example of the latter is the American Fencing League, distinct from the United States Fencing Association. The format of competitions is different and the right-of-way rules are interpreted in a different way. In a number of countries, school and university matches deviate slightly from the five format. A variant of the sport using toy lightsabers earned national attention when ESPN2 acquired the rights to a selection of matches and included it as part of its ESPN8, the Ocho programming block in August 2018. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.